There are a lot of malfunctions to the replay system. There are a lot of mistakes made even with the replay system. So to me, now, with this system here, okay, I must have explained it wrong. My point was, you are letting a machine project the travel path of the ball. It is projecting the travel path of the ball. So it is I got the thing here now that this is what it says. Using statistics, speed, break, location, trajectory, they come up with data that they then use to enhance the calculation. You're bringing a lot of stuff with no analysis from the human element into it. So on a pitch, who's wrong there? The umpire? But the way they displayed it, they made it seem that he was egregiously wrong on that pitch. And that pitch to Villa, to me, was on the corner. It was debatable. But it was either a ball in or a ball out. It wasn't five balls out. I mean, they had one strike out last night where he went in a strike zone on any of the three. So to me, the flight of the ball as it passes the plate is what they're trying to give you. Okay? But as they do that, it's a projection because it's all these calculations. It's not like they're taking an infrared. Like if they were taking a light and using a sensor and doing it, I would think they probably would be, you know, if they were doing like a sensor as it came across the plate and they would sensor it, that would probably be more accurate, I guess. But I don't think they do that because it says here that the system tracks every pitch from the time it leaves the pitcher's hand until it crosses the plate, calculating key statistics, speed, break, location, type, trajectory, and that's how it comes up with its projection. Well, why wouldn't you just put some kind of, now I'm not a scientist, but why wouldn't you put some kind of infrared thing around the plate, and as the ball passes the plate, just generate where it is in relation to the plate? Wouldn't that be a better idea? And you can see where, here's the plate, and it's either in or it's out or it's up or it's down, and you could say how many inches off. See, if you had the plate, and the plate had these things sticking up, like, you know, like rays or, you know, the kind of beams from the plate, and you could say the pitch was 1/18 an inch outside, or the pitch was X number of inches high. Now, that would be, this number of inches is a strike to this number of inches is a strike, and it was this number of inches high. So you'd know if it was inside those two numbers or not. Then I think you got calculations that are probably accurate. This thing last night, you got balls that are in the strike zone. He's calling them low. Now, did that mean when it crossed the plate that it was there, or did it go up, or was it down? Some of these balls are big breaking balls, and you know some of them are moving in and out. So to me, you're winding up with calculations or projections rather than pure flights of the ball. I mean, that's how it sounds to me. So, I'm not a scientist. But to me, I look at it and say, all right, if it's down the middle, you know it's down the middle. It's in the middle of this thing, okay? If it's outside, it's outside. But they had some last night that were way outside that he was calling strikes. Now, does that mean his strike zone? It didn't look to me like he was as far off the plate as the machine was making him. That's how I took it. And I also thought the machine had a little trouble with the ball that was coming back over the plate late. You know, which sometimes that ball comes in and it goes over the plate, but it's gone over the plate late. Sometimes it's gone over the plate at the right time. So, you know, you get that late movement on the ball too, which I think it has a little trouble with. So I don't want to marry it and turn it into like I'm just watching that, not watching the game, is my point. I didn't mean to say that it wasn't following the flight across the plate. It is, but it's putting a projection of the flight, not the final flight of the ball. It's putting a projection of the flight of the ball, is my point. So I don't know if that's totally accurate. I don't know. I don't take it as being totally accurate. I'm sure they can come up with a system that would somehow be used by, you know, putting some kind of lasers into the plate itself. But, I mean, if we get to that point and you just beep if it's a strike, then you don't need an umpire. Just have someone there call safe or out. I don't like that. I don't like to take that. I don't want to live in the, you know, rollerball era. I don't want to live in some space age era where everything is robotic. I don't want to do that. I'd rather have guys make mistakes and you argue. I mean, you can live with that. Tom in Long Island, what's up, Tom?
Hey, Mike, thanks for taking the call.
What's happening?
Yeah, I totally agree. He can do away with all that George Jetson stuff on the screen.
Just, yeah, you know, just
play the game. Ball to strike.
Yeah, I agree.
Kick it old school. I got two questions for you. One's kind of a trivia question, and one's just kind of an opinion. If the